Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Buenas tardes.
Buenas tardes.
Thank you first, my brother priest, Brother Jerome, and Joseph, David, and Brother Peter for being here celebrating this Eucharist. And all of you who make time to come and live here and think about our history. Sometimes in life we have distractions that move us our focus from one place to another place. And the distractions sometimes make to take control of the mind. What is history? And how we can live out of history? St. Paul, in the first reading, he greets a lot of people, all of them who were part of his life. And he greets his fellow parishioners. He mentioned that, my fellow parishioners. How we, in our own history, the Black Catholic history, the Native American history, how we make a space to see the presence of Jesus through the different people who work with us. If we see the Old Testament, what is the history of salvation, it's not a nice thing to read. It's a lot of dysfunctional things. But always is God presence there. What is the key? Is to be able to recognize Him in our daily lives. All of us here, doesn't matter where we're coming from, we carry our own history. We have our own stories to tell. And it's not a perfect one at all. Some parts of our own we like to put aside. We don't like to see that. But how do we make from our own lives that we become part of that history of salvation? How we allow God to be part of our own history. How do we make Him to relive that moment and help us to live the moment in His love and to start to make a difference? And that is the life of the saints. The life of the saints are not an easy life. We see their lives from here, but if we look in closer, the character that we have, San Martin de Porres, the life was not easy at all. And what made them special is they opened themselves to grace. They opened themselves to recognize God's presence in their own lives. And through that, things changed. Not only for them, but for the people who surround them. Life is not easy in any way, and we have a nice group of young people here. That you are challenged in your daily lives with different things. They invite you to be crazy. Crazy? Yes, you need to become crazy, but in a good sense. Not crazy in the way that you will hurt yourself. Crazy in the way that you accept the challenge to become better and better. The best version of who you are. And that is the life of the saints. How we see each one of us, African American, Native American, we see our own history and we make that then a way of salvation, a way of freedom. In the middle of everything is hope. And how we are able to see hope in my life. For something good. Not to escape and find an easy way to escape. It's not a way to fill our hearts with anger and frustration, but it's how we can look in for something there. It's easy, it's not at all. But we need to become as strong spiritually, emotionally. We need to bring hope to the world today. And the example that we have are the life of the saints. History, our own history, bring sometimes black clouds in the past. But how we can, through the black clouds in the past, learn something for today and make the present day a moment of salvation and grace and love? What is there in our past who is teaching us to do something different and open ourselves to be touched by grace and by love? And that would be the key to make a difference and write our own history in a different way to see life. We have faith, we have our church, and sometimes being part of the family of the church is not easy. Every family has their own distinction of names. All of us, we have that in our own families. But how we embrace that and how through that we make the best in our life. Life is there, history is there, to be able to read in crooked lines how God has been always with us and bring us always hope. We need to ask the Lord to open our eyes to that, to awaken ourselves the desire of the saints to be close to Him, and in a very simple way, make difference. Make a difference. It's beautiful to read the life of the saints. And one of the most interesting things in the life of the saints is the simple way in which they lived their lives, and through that, how they were able to make the difference. Not so extraordinary things, but in a very ordinary way. We need to ask the Lord to help us to see our own first, our own, and how we have been able to make room for God to be part of my own, and how free I have been to let Him to work with me first, with us first, to give us freedom, escape from slavery of sin, and be able to have the freedom to start to see life through the eyes of God. You know, to do a difference in life, to be open, to make a difference, and make a difference in history, is how we first start to see one eye with the eyes of God. How God looks on you. How He looks on you, and what He sees in you, and how He feels in love with you. And that is the power to transform life and give the freedom to do something great. And something is great is have the freedom to dream big. When we are unable to dream, the heart is almost dead because it's not hope. Is always something good in the heart of each one of us. And the challenge is with the grace and help of Jesus, find it and make a difference and be free to be who you are and become a saint in the world today that we need the most. We continue this beautiful celebration, looking each one our own past, how we have been able to let Jesus work through that and give us the freedom that we need to live this moment and make a difference and live for the future.